Do you know the name of my stick? My stick has a very special name. Hi everybody, this is Mr Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? Are you feeling happy today? I hope so. Here we are then. Yes, another day in lockdown. Live from England for those watching around the world, or perhaps you are also watching in England as well. How are you spending your Friday in lockdown? For those who are in lockdown, of course. Not everyone around the world is doing that. And I suppose it's fair to say not everyone here in the UK is doing it, because it is only here in England. We are now in lockdown. So today, of course, today is no ordinary day, because it is Friday the 13th. For some people, they believe it is an unlucky day, because Friday and the 13th falling at the same time is considered unlucky. For those who are superstitious, they believe that on this day bad things will happen. You have to take care of what you are doing. A good example, of course, is what I did at the start of today's live stream. Did you see over there my ladder? I walked underneath the ladder. Some people believe that if you walk underneath a ladder, it will bring bad luck. There are many superstitions around in the world. Walking under a ladder is just one of them. However, there are many others as well. For example, in some countries, people believe that if a black cat crosses your path, that is also unlucky. However, some people believe that if a black cat walks in front of you, it will bring good luck. It depends, you see. Some people believe that you should never put a pair of shoes on a table, especially a new pair of shoes, for those who are superstitious, you see. Hello to the live chat. By the way, my stick, the name of my stick is Gandalf, because I think this stick looks a little bit like the large stick that Gandalf carried in Lord of the Rings. So I think my stick looks very much like J.R. Tolkien's character walking around, putting things right. You shall not pass. You shall not pass. What is the secret password? Mr. Duncan, get on with it. That apparently is today's secret password. You are welcome to say that as often as you want. So we are live. Yes, for those who are wondering, what the hell is this? How did I get to this weird man? Well, my name is Duncan. I talk about the English language quite often. I will also talk about various subjects. So the reason why I'm here today is because myself, just like everyone else here in England, many of us are still in lockdown. So this is now the second week of lockdown. So I thought, after my rather successful live stream on Wednesday, when I was up on the roof. Did you see my live stream? Yes, I was talking live on Wednesday whilst putting up my Christmas lights. I haven't quite finished the job because today it's been raining. So at the moment I am underneath my little gazebo. But this morning when I woke up, the sun was shining. It was a beautiful day. However, around about 50 minutes ago, we had quite a lot of rain, so that's the reason why I am now under cover. Although I am still outside in the garden, so don't worry about that. Yes, this is my lucky stick. So because I am experiencing the feeling of being live on Friday the 13th, I thought I should have my lucky stick. So that's the reason why it's here. You might even describe this as my precious. Sorry about that. That was a terrible impression of Gollum. So here we go. We have the live chat, by the way. Hello to the live chat. Nice to see you here today. I wonder how many people will be joining us. I wonder. Hello to Nassar, Mosen, Rosa, Ahmed, Zudzika. Hello, Zudzika. I haven't seen you for a while. Nice to see you back on the live stream as well. It is time to have a cup of tea. Have a nice day. Oh, I see. So it looks as if Zudzika is about to refresh herself with a cup of tea. Hello, also, Luis Mendez is here today. What does the word panic mean? If you panic, it means you go into a state of fear, quite often uncontrollable. So if you suddenly become uncontrollably scared or afraid, maybe the feeling appears very suddenly. We can describe it as panic. So panic might, it might look like this. Oh my goodness, Mr. Duncan is on. Oh no, I better hurry up and get to my computer. I am panicking because I might be late for the start of Mr. Duncan's live stream. Oh my goodness. What am I going to do? So that's what panic looks like. A person who panics, they lose control of their emotions. They become filled with the feeling of fear. Or I suppose you could say anxiety as well, because when we think of anxiety, we think of fear. People who have panic attacks, sometimes you can have a sudden feeling of fear that is uncontrollable. You cannot control the feeling of fear. So panic is something that happens suddenly, a sudden feeling of fear, normally caused by a certain thing, maybe something that you weren't expecting, maybe something that happens by surprise, maybe the feeling of being late for work. So maybe you are late for work, you will panic, you will suddenly be in a rush, you see? Hello, Rosa. Hello, Beatrice. Hello, Vina. Also, we have DM. DM Harina Nguyen. I believe you are watching in Vietnam, if I'm not mistaken. Nice to see so many people here. I don't know how long I'm going to be on for today, but I will be here. Another thing to mention, somewhere around here, Mr. Steve is lurking. He is doing some work in the garden. So Steve is somewhere around here. I don't know where, but he is nearby. That I can promise. So we might see Mr. Steve because he is taking the day off. He's actually having a holiday today. So we have spent the morning together, but I couldn't resist coming on today just to say hello. So I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind sharing a little bit of time with me today. Hello to Partap. Oh, hello, Partap. Is it your birthday again? Just in case. Happy birthday, Partap. Again. For another one of your fake birthdays. I love it. I like it a lot. Hello, also, the Glasses Monster. I haven't seen you for a long time either. Hello, the Glasses Monster. I remember you. You used to join me on my live streams every Sunday. Yes, I remember that. Hello, also, Abdalim, watching in Morocco. Ooh, I am wondering what the weather is like in Morocco. Is the weather nice or is it a little bit horrible? What is the weather like where you are? It feels very autumnal today. I'm going to be honest with you, it's very autumnal, very damp, even though this morning the sun was out. and I thought we were going to have a lovely day. Is panic the same as perplex? No, it isn't. Perplex means to be confused or maybe bewildered by something. So perplex is a little different. It is a different word. Panic is the sudden feeling of fear. Perplexed is the feeling of being slightly confused or disorientated. Hello, Mr. Duncan. I love the way you explain things. Thank you, Guadalupe. It's very kind of you to say. Yes, Mr. Steve is having the day off, even though he's in the garden somewhere. I don't know where he is, but he might make an appearance. I'm not sure. I'm not going to promise you, but Mr. Steve might be appearing on today's live stream. We will have to wait and see. Yes, if you baffle someone, you are baffled. You are confused. You are perplexed by something. Something confuses you. Hello, Helen. Helen Farman, who says, oh, I'm so enthusiastic. Thank you very much. It's nice to know that you feel eager and enthusiastic as well. Thank you also to, oh, the Glasses Monster says, thank you for remembering me. Well, of course, for those who are always on my live streams watching, I do remember your names. Sometimes it takes a long time for me to remember the names, but I do. I try my best to remember the names. Hello also. Oh, we have Abbas. Hello, Abbas. Hello to you as well. I hope you are safe and well where you are in the world. So as I mentioned, we are into our second week of lockdown. So many people are having to stay at home. We have to isolate ourselves. However, I suppose it's important to mention that we are allowed to go out for exercise nearby to where we live. Or maybe you can go shopping as well. So this morning, can I show you something? I will put Gandalf over here. Excuse me. To be honest, I don't really need Gandalf. So this morning we went shopping. Can I show you something? Because last week, the local shop in Much Wenlock had some cases of coronavirus. So they had to close the shop and clean everywhere inside the shop. But around about five or six people who worked there all tested positive. So they had to go home, they had to close the shop, and they had to clean everything. So this morning, Mr. Steve and myself, we went shopping. I will show you what I bought first. Can you guess what I bought? I have something in my hand. Can you guess what it is? I will give you a clue. It's something I like very much. So what did I buy in the supermarket here in Much Wenlock this morning? What did I buy for myself? Hello, Ricardo. Panic can be a superior state of fear, can't it? Yes, I would say panic is probably one of the highest points of fear or the feeling of being afraid. Panic. You run around. Your body. Maybe your body will start to go into a certain situation called fight or flight. So quite often when you panic, your body will react as well. You will react physically, not just mentally, but also physically as well. Your body will produce lots of adrenaline to make your heart race and your breathing become deeper. So the reason why it does that, of course, goes back to when man was in the jungle running around with all the other wild animals. And of course, to survive, you have to either fight or flight. So you fight or flight. It means you attack or defend yourself, or of course you run away. So that's why we say that. So your body will produce something called adrenaline. Your adrenaline will go around your bloodstream. Your heart will go fast. Your brain will become more active. And suddenly you will have lots of energy. However, some people can have the adrenaline go around their body even if they're not panicking. So that is one of the problems that can sometimes arise with a person. Advocate. Hello, Advocate Singh Rana. You are getting old. What happened? What happened? Well, we're all getting old. I'm getting older. You're getting older. Even the trees behind me are getting older. Even though they will be around many years after I've just departed this mortal coil. Hello, T.S. Oh, hello, T.S. I haven't seen you for a long time. I was talking about you last week. Mr. Steve was talking to me about some of my viewers, and he mentioned your name. He asked, is T.S. still there? I haven't seen T.S. for a long time. Ah, interesting. Why are you wearing your Donald Trump hat? This is not Donald Trump hat. This is not a Donald Trump hat. How dare you? Now, this is my red hat that I've put on because I'm wearing my red shirt, you see. But no, this has nothing to do with politics. My hat and my shirt have nothing to do with politics whatsoever. So no, I'm not. So, Mr. White Cis Male, I am not wearing my Trump hat because it isn't, you see. It's a sport hat. When I walk around scaring the wildlife, I like to wear this hat. Hello also to Mosin. No one stays young. That is true. You can't stay young forever. It's impossible. So even if you are 20 or 30 or 40 or 110 or 140, you are always getting older. Even if you don't feel it, you are slowly getting older. It is something that happens gradually. It happens slowly over time. As I always say, don't worry about it. Age is just a number. It doesn't really matter. You are only as old as you feel. That's what I say. What did I buy from the supermarket this morning? Can you guess? I'm looking for some interesting answers. What did I buy? And then after that, I will show you. I will show you what I wore on my body this morning. So the two things I'm going to show you in a moment. What did I buy this morning? Anyone know? Does anyone know what I bought? What did I buy this morning? I'm getting some very, very clever comments this morning. Oh, well done. When I say this morning, I don't mean this morning here, because it isn't morning here. It's afternoon. In fact, now it is just after 2:30 in the afternoon. I hope you're having a good day. Yes. We are once again in lockdown. This is our second week. Did you buy some ladyfingers? For those who don't know what ladyfingers are, they are a type of sponge with some sugar on the top. So they are a thing that is normally put in desserts. You see? In desserts. So yes, I do have them in the house, but I didn't buy those this morning. I bought something else. Chocolate. Ah, interesting. Chocolate. What about hand sanitizer, Mr. Duncan? We have plenty of that already. And I will show you what I did this morning. I did something this morning to protect myself. I will show you in a moment. Hello also to... Oh, hello, Jojo. Jojo Adam. I don't recognise your name. Have you been here before? Is it your first time? Thank you also, Nikhil. Hello, Nikhil. Nikhil Guzaiwal. I hope I pronounce your name right. My throat is a bit strange again today. I don't know why. My voice sounds a little croaky. I think I've been using it too much, as usual. Maybe your new hat, or maybe... Oh, maybe you bought a new hat this morning. Or maybe some new electronic equipment. No, none of those things. No. I will give you a clue. It is something to eat. Yes. I think you're going to guess. I think so. Something to eat. What about me? I just want to know where the ladder goes. Well, the ladder at the moment is leaning against the wall. So in the distance, you can see in my garden, I have my ladder. And that is the ladder that I've been using all week to climb up and down on the roof. Oh, did I pronounce your name right? Thank you. Thank you, Nikhil. That's very kind of you to say. Sometimes I do have difficulty pronouncing your names. Sometimes. Not always, but sometimes. Oh. Hello also, Lama. Lama Ali. Nice to see you as well. Did you buy some vegetables and fruit this morning? Well, actually, yes. So that is one of the things that I bought this morning. I bought some potatoes and also some, oh, something called cauliflower. Have you ever tried to eat cauliflower? It is one of my most favourite vegetables. I love it. Hello, white cis male. Again. Do you have COVID? Do I have it? No, I don't. Fortunately for me, I don't. I don't have it. Well, as far as I know, anyway. This morning, I went to the supermarket. I bought some vegetables. I bought some fruit. I bought some biscuits. And also, I bought some Jaffa cakes. Of course, I'm surprised that no one guessed this. I thought you were going to guess this straight away, you see. I thought so. Jaffa cakes, one of my favourite snacks. And as you can see here, there are, how many? 18 Jaffa cakes in this box. And before anyone says anything, because I'm sure you will, and so will Mr. Steve, he will say that, Mr. Duncan, you are going to eat all of those in one go. No, I'm not. I promise. Oh, Lama says, I like cauliflower. It is amazing how many people don't eat cauliflower. Now, cauliflower, for me, is one of my most favourite vegetables. And one of the reasons why I love cauliflower so much is because Mr. Steve makes the most amazing cauliflower cheese. Have you ever tried it? So what you do, you cook the cauliflower. You normally cook it in boiling water until it's slightly soft, and then you put lots of melted cheese over it, and then you put it in the oven for around about 10 or 15 minutes, and then when you take it out, you have the most gorgeous side dish. It's making me feel quite hungry now. It's making me feel very hungry. Hello, Nova. Hello, Nova. Nova Vika Crafts. Hello to you. Can you please say hello to me? Hello. Luis Mendez says, cauliflower is a very good starter. I agree with you. I agree. It's a very nice side dish. Even in Indian cooking, so quite often in Indian food, you will find cauliflower is often used. What is cauliflower? Maybe Mr. Steve will show us. Perhaps Mr. Steve will bring the cauliflower out to show you. Or maybe I could get it myself. We will see. The view behind, oh, hello. The view behind you is very beautiful, Mr. Duncan. Thank you very much. It is the garden. It is looking rather green. And you might also be able to see there are lots of, oh, lo- lots of leaves as well blowing around. So over the past couple of days, we've had some rather strong winds, some big storms, including last night. We had a lot of rain last night. So that's the reason why you can see lots of leaves around the garden. I think these particular leaves have come from a tree called a silver birch. Let me just have a look. I think so, yes. So this particular leaf is from a tree called a silver birch. There it is. I hope you can see it clearly. It might not focus. There we go. A silver birch leaf. And there are hundreds and hundreds of these in the garden at the moment. Quite a few, in fact. Yes, Mr. Steve will be coming on soon. Don't worry, we will have a little bit of Mr. Steve. I don't know how long he will be here for, but we will have Mr. Steve with us. I'm hoping he will bring something to show us. Maybe he will bring the cauliflower. Is that a good idea? So we can talk about our vegetables, the things we like to eat. Hello also to... Oh, we have Beatrice. I can only eat cauliflower in pickles and no other way. I also like broccoli quite a lot. Me too. I love broccoli. One of my favourite side dishes, especially when I have Chinese food, garlic broccoli. Have you ever tried it? So you can have broccoli, but then you put garlic on the top and then you bake the garlic or cook the garlic. It's absolutely delicious. Garlic and broccoli. Oh, hello. We have a lot of people joining now. Hello to Achundong. Achundong Charlotte. A lot of leaves will make the view a little bit better. I think so. I love seeing the leaves fall. There is nothing nicer than looking outside and watching the leaves fall during the autumn months. I love it. Ricardo says, I have found that Jaffa Cake is a generic name. It is not registered by the original maker. You are right, yes. So there are many brands of Jaffa Cake. So even though this one is called Jaffa Cake or Jaffa Cakes, and this is made by a company called McVitie's, which I'm not advertising, by the way, in case anyone says, Mr. Duncan, you're advertising. No, I'm not. I'm not being sponsored by anyone. No one wants to sponsor me. I don't know why. Can you guess? Jaffa Cakes. So yes, this is actually a generic name. So there are many different companies making Jaffa Cakes. Many different companies. Hopefully Mr. Steve will be here soon, and I'm hoping he will bring out the cauliflower to show us. So we will see what happens. I will use my psychic power to transmit my thoughts into Mr. Steve's head. Let's see if it works. Mr. Steve, if you can hear me, please, can you bring the cauliflower outside to show us? Because everyone is interested. They want to see it. Ooh. Message received, apparently. Hello, El Picasso. Is this a political ad? I don't think so. I'm not aware that I'm talking about politics today. Maybe you're talking about it, but I'm not talking about it at all. Interesting. Can you hear that sound? That sound is actually a sparrow. A sparrow, and it is very alarmed. A sparrow. Hello, Mr. Sparrow, don't worry. I won't harm you. It's all right. Have you ever tried cauliflower rice? No, I've never tried that. It sounds rather interesting. Cauliflower and rice. Very nice. As I mentioned just, Mr. Steve makes the most amazing cauliflower cheese. It is absolutely gorgeous. Can you hear behind me? You can hear the sparrows. And they are panicking, you see. So that is the sound that sparrows make when they are panicking. Maybe they are afraid of me. I wonder why. Yes, I can hear the birds. Look to Ty says, I can hear the birds. There are many birds around at the moment because at this time of year, of course, most of the insects will disappear. So the birds will suddenly become very desperate for food. And in my garden, there are lots of bird feeders, lots of seed, lots of peanuts, lots of delicious food for the birds to eat. No, that bird is not happy at all. Sometimes birds can be very afraid, especially of things that might be flying around, such as buzzards. So around here we get many birds of prey. Birds of prey. They fly around looking for a nice juicy bird to eat. Yes. Yes, there are many leaves on the ground because we are now into autumn. Autumn has arrived. It has. I think you look younger than your real age, sir. Thank you very much. That's very kind of you. A lot of people say that I don't act like my age, which is true. Some people say I'm immature. I don't think so. So there is no rule. No rule. If you want to act like a young person, even if you are getting older, it doesn't matter. Some people like it. Some people find it very attractive, in fact. Some people believe that being happy in your life can actually help you to stay well and live longer. Ooh, nice. Fly Audi says, I had one sparrow entering my house and he was trying to escape from something. It is a very strange situation when a bird goes into your house. Have you ever had that happen? When a bird flies into your window and into your room, they will often start to panic. They will go into a panic because they don't know what to do. It is a strange environment. They're not used to it. So sometimes, yes, it can happen. Yes, there are many birds of prey flying around here. We have buzzards. We have kestrels, and they are all in the wild, flying around. Sometimes in the afternoon, you can see the buzzards flying overhead, searching for their next meal. So what did I do this morning? When I went shopping with Mr. Steve, I decided to take extra care. So besides my face mask, which I did wear, I also put something else on as well. I wore a pair of rubber gloves. So I actually went shopping this morning and I actually wore not only my mask across my face, but also I had some rubber gloves as well, just to make sure. I will show you. Here we go. So these are very similar to the gloves that they wear in hospitals, very similar. You are probably wondering, Mr. Duncan, why do you own rubber gloves? I don't know what you mean. So there we go. Look at that. Some nice protective gloves. And this is what I wore this morning in the supermarket. So can you imagine going around the supermarket wearing a face mask? And also a pair of rubber gloves as well. A lot of people were looking at me. But I wanted to make sure that I was protected, you see, from you know what. You know what I'm talking about. So I wanted to make sure that I did not get any germs from the shop. Because last week there were some members of staff who came down with coronavirus. They actually caught it. So they had to go home. So that's what I did this morning. I wore my rubber gloves. So what about you? Have you been protecting yourself with your face mask? Sometimes I see people wearing the large plastic visor as well. There is something you can put on your head and there is a large piece of plastic that comes down the front. And that is called a face visor. A visor. So the visor is something you can look through. You can see through it. It is clear. Quite often made of plastic or sometimes glass. Visor. So some people are using those as well. Oh. Hello, Tracy Blaine. What a boat. Forensic suits. I have no idea what you mean by that. Absolutely no idea. El Picasso says visors are ridiculous. Mr. Steve also thinks the same thing. He says, why do people wear the visor? They have a visor over their face. But all of the germs and the virus can get behind the virus, the visor. So I don't think the visor is a very good form of protection. I think the face mask is much better. I think so. Jojo says, Mr. Duncan, please do not shave your beard. It looks very beautiful on you. Thank you very much. Someone said the other day, they said, Mr. Duncan, your beard is a little bit like salt and pepper. So apparently some men, as they get older, their beard will be white with other colours as well. Dark and light mixed together. So someone said the other day that my beard is a little bit like salt and pepper. Interesting. It also makes me mature, apparently. Yes. Well, it is the only thing that makes me look mature, because I'm not mature in any other way, apparently. I hope one day to meet you, says Helen. Thank you, Helen. It's very kind of you. Maybe, you never know, in this world. Anything, and I mean anything, is possible. Hello also to, oh, we have quite a few people joining now. Can I say hello to Cherry Lynn? Hello, Cherry Lynn. We call it a plastic face shield. Yes, I suppose so. You could describe that thing as a face shield. So when we say shield, we mean something that protects you. It is keeping things away, or keeping things away from the thing you are trying to protect. Shield. That's a great word, by the way. So you can shield yourself with a plastic visor. Yes, I think so. You can do that. From my own opinion, I think the face mask is much better for protecting yourself. I remember when I was living in China, because I did spend a few years living in China, working there, and I was actually there during the SARS crisis. So way back in 2003, I was actually living I was living in China, and I was there during the SARS crisis. So everyone had to go into lockdown. So this, for me, it's not the first time I've experienced lockdown. We've actually had it before. Well, I experienced it when I was living in China, way back in 2003. Mr. Duncan, when you stroke your beard, you look more intellectual. Really? Oh, I will try it. Hmm. Well, did it work? Did I look more intellectual? I don't know. Hello, Maria. Do you have to wear the mask and visor for the eyes? The only thing you have to wear here is the face mask. So as long as the covering is going over your nose and mouth, you are okay, you see? So you don't have to protect your eyes, but you do have to protect your nose and mouth. You have to cover them, especially if you are in a public place amongst other people. Did you work in China? Yes, I lived in China. Many years ago, I worked there as an English teacher. And thank you for your very interesting messages today, by the way. Yes, I was there working as an English teacher. I was there for a few years. A wonderful experience. A wonderful experience. It is interesting how travel can broaden your mind. You can see things that you thought you would never ever see. So I think sometimes it is very interesting. Very interesting. Traveling to other countries, experiencing other cultures as well. Very important. It's a very good thing. The plastic mask is too exaggerated. I think so. Yes, I also think that maybe the plastic visor will not protect you because everything can go behind it. It can go behind and into your nose. So if I had a choice between the plastic visor or the face mask made of cloth, I would choose the face mask every time. Hello, Mr. Steve. Oh,
let me just come and say hello. Well.
Look who it is, everyone. It's Mr. Steve.
Hello.
What are you doing?
Well, I was going to do some gardening, but then I thought it's a bit dangerous out here because there's a big ladder. And you know what they say about going underneath ladders?
They say it's bad luck, especially today, because today is Friday the 13th.
Yes. What's going to happen?
What about you, Steve? Steve, are you superstitious about today?
A little bit. A little bit.
A little bit.
Yes.
Idiandiam, as they say in Chinese.
Clever clods.
Okay.
Well, I've been doing some gardening, Mr. Duncan. So that, in theory, on Friday the 13th could be unlucky. Because I don't want to chop a finger off.
No.
I've already chopped the top off my gardening gloves.
Yeah, so you have to be careful. You are really putting yourself at risk today.
Anything could happen.
Anything.
A tree could fall on me. I might chop my leg off. I might put the fork into my feet. through my Wellington boots.
Please tell me that you didn't just forget the name of the things at the end of your legs.
Yes, feet.
Feet.
F-E-E-T. Yes, I've got very... have you noticed my very old hat?
This hat, by the way. This hat is really old. Look, it's falling to pieces.
So this used to be a trendy hat that I would wear when I was out and about, trying to impress anybody. So this used to be something, but I think this must be probably 20 years old.
Yes, I think, is it Nike? I think it is, it's Nike, yes. But this is old. This is old, and this is older.
Thanks a lot. It'll be unlucky for you, Mr. Duncan, in a minute.
It is very worn out. It is falling to pieces, it is worn out, and it needs throwing away. And also, the hat as well.
Friday the 13th could be very unlucky for you, Mr. Duncan.
Really? You know what we were talking about earlier? No. Did you receive my psychic message?
No.
Did you? I was sending you a psychic message earlier. I don't think Mr. Steve...
I felt very unhappy earlier, so maybe that was it.
Oh, I see. So What I was talking about earlier was vegetables, because we went shopping this morning.
Yes. You're talking about yourself, were you? Sorry, sorry. Vegetables. Vegetable.
Oh, I see.
If you describe someone as a vegetable, it means they haven't got much intelligence.
Yes.
Upstairs.
A person who might be a bit duh might be described as a vegetable. It's not a very nice word, by the way. Thank you, Steve, for introducing that. Cauliflower. Apparently, a lot of people are fans of cauliflower. However, some people have never seen it before.
Do you want me to go and fetch it, Mr. Duncan?
Would you like to go and fetch the cauliflower?
I'll take my gloves off because we're going to be eating that cauliflower tomorrow.
Yes.
We don't want it to be covered in mud.
Okay, quickly.
Quickly.
Kuaijiao, kuaijiao, kuaijiao. In Chinese, if you want someone to hurry up, you will say kuaijiao, 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 aiya. Hurry up, Mr. Steve. If only it has cheese. Yes, well, Mr. Steve is very good at making cauliflower cheese. It is something that maybe one day we could show you. Maybe we can make a video making Mr. Steve's lovely cauliflower cheese. No one could see that, Steve.
I'll do it again, shall I? I've got my boots on.
I've never seen Steve so enthusiastic.
There we go.
That's a big one.
And the cauliflower. Oh dear, Mr. Duncan. Right, here we go. This is what it looks like. Do you want to demonstrate, because you're quite good at that sort of thing?
There's not much to explain, really, is there? It's a cauliflower, for God's sake. There we go. So there, you can see on the outside, there are some green leaves, but the most important part is inside, you see. Look at that. So there is a, we call this, I believe this is called the heart.
Yes.
Yes. So this part is the heart of the cauliflower. So there it is. It is just a big, giant clump. But you can boil this in water. You can slowly steam this. And then afterwards, if you are like Mr. Steve, oh, there's the word, look. Can you see it? There it is. Cauliflower. The spelling is very strange, but there it is.
It looks a bit like a brain.
Yes.
If you were to take somebody's skull off and have a look, it looks a bit like a white brain.
Yes, it does look like a brain. I wish my brain was this large. I don't think my brain is this large. Maybe my brain is the size of a Brussels sprout.
The only problem with cauliflower is it's a bit tasteless, but it absolutely stinks out your house when you're cooking it.
Yes.
The whole house smells of cooking cauliflower.
Yes.
But it's delicious. Have you been telling them about putting cheese sauce on it?
Yes, I mentioned it. You're famous. You're amazing. Mr. Steve's amazing. Mr. Steve's amazing cauliflower cheese. It's incredible. The most amazing thing I've ever tried.
Cauliflower, not broccoli.
No. Broccoli is small, and normally that's green. Cauliflower is large and white.
You can get big, you can get quite big broccolis.
Mm.
But the colour, they are quite similar. I think they're, in terms of a vegetable, they're very closely related, I think.
Yes.
Except one is white and goes very well with cheese if you put it in the oven with cheese sauce on and make it go all brown on the top.
Yes. So you can actually bake the cauliflower and the cheese together. And Mr. Steve makes the most amazing cauliflower cheese. We're having that tomorrow, by the way, with potatoes and lamb shank.
Ooh. Yes, lamb goes well with cheese and cauliflower. Jojo is a pickling cauliflower.
Oh, okay then.
Yes, we're pickling cauliflower. Now, I've never tried that. I would imagine you'd have it cold, but yes, it's quite a versatile vegetable.
Mm.
Versatile, that means you can do a lot with it.
Yes, but it's amazing how many people don't like cauliflower, especially the smell, as you mentioned earlier. So when you're boiling or maybe steaming cauliflower, it can have quite an unpleasant smell, I think so.
But we like it, and with lamb shank sounds like prison food, says El Picasso.
I know why you're saying that, because, of course, a shank, when we say the word shank, it can also mean a knife that has been fashioned in prison to be used as a weapon, you see. So that's... I know what you're talking about. See? You see? It because of my brief time in prison, when I was locked up
bad.
For my crime of passion, I was in prison, and it was I had to survive. They used to pass me around like currency.
Mr. Duncan.
But...
I was the same. But, you know, younger years.
Anyway.
Yes, so the shank is like, isn't it, the part of the top bit of the leg.
Thigh.
The thigh bone.
So imagine the thigh bone. So sometimes from the front leg, or sometimes if you want a really nice big lamb shank, you can have the back leg. But yes, it's the bone, the femur.
That goes through the top piece of your leg.
Yes, so the bone is called the femur. Femur.
You sure about that, Mr. Duncan?
I am very sure. I was very good
at... He does know his bones.
I was very good at biology at school.
You had a skeleton at home, as well as one in the cupboard. Many skeletons in the cupboard, Mr. Duncan.
Are you okay?
No, I'm on a high. Well, of course, if we say that someone's got skeletons in their cupboard,
mm-hmm.
What do we mean, Mr. Duncan?
They have... A dark secret.
Secrets that they don't want people to know about.
Mm. So if you have a skeleton in your cupboard or in your closet, it means there is something from your past that you don't want other people to know about.
Ooh. For example, you could be a politician,
mm-hmm.
and you could have had an affair with somebody, and it would be wouldn't go... down very well politically if it was revealed.
No.
So you keep it a secret. So that could be a skeleton in your cupboard. Or you could have done some dodgy deal somewhere. Or you could have committed a crime. But you're in public office. It's often used for people in public office, isn't it? Who could be exposed for misdemeanors in the past.
So something you've done wrong. Something from your past that you don't want other people to know about can be described as a skeleton. In the cupboard.
It's always something quite big, quite major.
Yes. Maybe you've got 6 children by different women, you know who?
A certain prime minister.
A certain prime minister of a certain country that is not very far away from here.
Oh, we're making people hungry.
Oh, really?
Oh, look, my wife tells me, says Lewis, that cauliflower and cheese is called gratin.
Catine de chou-fleur.
Chou-fleur. What? I bet it's nicer in France, because I bet they use that lovely French cheese. See, we would use hard cheddar cheese. And yes. But I also put... So I make a white sauce, which is flour and milk, basically, with a little bit of butter in it.
Mm.
And then I melt the cheese in, but I also put some mustard in there as well, and lots of pepper. So it gives it a little bit of spice.
Sounds fantastic.
We'll be having it tomorrow, Mr. Duncan.
I want it now. Can you go into the kitchen now and make it?
I could do. We could have it tonight. But normally Friday night for us is curry night.
Curry night on Friday night?
Normally. I think it will be tonight.
Yes, we'll have curry tonight.
I'm not working today, am I, Mr. Duncan?
I need to make sure I can have a big poo tomorrow.
There's no answer to that.
Well, it always guarantees it, you see. If you have a curry, you are guaranteed a nice big poo.
Not necessarily.
Sometimes not.
Sometimes it blocks us up.
Anyway.
No rhyme or reason to it.
Okay, then.
But no, I'm on here today because I'm not working. I'm taking the day off.
Steve is having a couple of days off because it's just the stress, you see.
Oh, yes, the stress. Because I have to work so hard at home. It is quite difficult working from... Where's Mr. Duncan going? He can hear an aeroplane. Yes. Look at the ego. He thinks that they're actually... They know him and they might wave back. They might drop a bomb on him.
I'm just waving to the man in the helicopter.
It's a helicopter.
Yeah.
We've had quite a few helicopters go over the last few days.
Yes.
2 came over very low over the house. Was it yesterday or the day before?
Yes, well, we do live about 12 miles away from an airbase.
Well, there's one way and one the other.
Yes.
Blimey, if there was ever a world war, we wouldn't stand much of a chance here, Mr. Duncan, because the first place they'd bomb would be airfields.
That's great. This is really cheering me up.
You
know,
it's true.
You know, the reason why I'm here today is to cheer everyone up. And all you're doing is depressing me a lot.
It smells like sulfur, says Alexandra. Yes, it can do. Some vegetables do smell a bit sort of sulfury when they're cooking.
Yes. Especially when you're cooking it.
Picasso, it's a good name. Are you an artiste by any chance?
Oh, I think definitely an artist, a certain type of artist.
Was the searchlight on? No, but they were obviously looking for you because you are an escaped convict.
I think for a moment there, I was in the crosshairs. I was definitely in their crosshairs then. They were focusing in on me.
How long is England in lockdown, says Heartsweet?
We are in lockdown until December the 2nd. However, and it is a very big however, we might actually be going on longer than that, you see. So some people are now saying that the lockdown might continue for much longer than just 4 weeks. And of course, have you noticed that Christmas is on the way? Because on Wednesday, I was putting the Christmas lights on the house and they look lovely. I haven't turned them on yet because it's a bit too early. But yes, so Christmas is coming. But some people now believe that we might still be in lockdown at Christmas. Can you imagine that?
Oh, but good news this morning, Mr. Duncan. The R rate.
Okay.
The R rate is coming down. Do you talk about R rates in your country when it comes to coronavirus? It's all we ever hear on our news is the R rate is this, the R rate is that.
I'm going to be honest with you. I still don't fully understand all of the figures, all of the graphs and all of the models connected with coronavirus. All I know is it's a bug that is very annoying and it's causing a lot of illness, a lot of loss of life, and that's it really. So the only thing I'm interested in is not getting it, to be honest.
Well, we had a bit of a close encounter, you could say, in much Wenlock.
Almost, yes.
In that the local supermarket, when I say supermarket, it's quite small. Would you call it a supermarket?
Well, it is a supermarket.
Yes, but it's not a big supermarket.
No, well,
a co-op, in fact. In fact, if you saw that the package that I showed up that had the cauliflower on, you would have seen the word co-op.
Okay.
Because that's the name of the shop. They're okay. Normally small shops, but yes.
Does that make the story any better?
Well, it does, because we found out that 7 members of the staff there had contracted coronavirus.
Yes, they tested positive for it.
And one's in hospital. Apparently, we don't know that for certain, but and we were in there the day after they were tested positive, and we didn't know they'd tested positive.
And this morning we went there again because we had to buy some Jaffa cakes, and also Mr. Steve needed some potatoes and some cauliflower for his meal tomorrow that he's going to make for me because I'm a very lucky man. But yes, we went there this morning, didn't we?
Well, we figure that probably now it's safer. But they don't wear gloves. I think that's a bit disconcerting when they're handling your food and your products that you're buying and they're putting them through the till.
Yes.
They're not wearing gloves, and I think they should. You were wearing gloves, weren't you, Mr.
I was
Duncan?
Wearing rubber gloves. I showed them earlier.
Oh, right.
So I had my mask, I had my rubber gloves, everything. Everything.
And you had to touch the keypad, didn't you, Mr. Duncan, on the what would you call it? The card reader where you pay.
Yeah, so when you use your debit card or credit card, you normally put your thing into the machine and then you have to enter a number. But of course, you can use contactless, which allows you to put your card on, beep, and you don't have to enter any numbers. However, there is a limit. I think it's £45.
I think you're right, Mr. Duncan.
So £45, anything over that, then you still have to enter the number with your fingers. Ugh.
Beatrice says that she is eating broccoli with garlic.
Nice.
I think you would like that.
Sounds good to
anything
me.
Anything with garlic. Is that hot or cold?
Yes, I mentioned that earlier because quite often with a Chinese meal, you'll have garlic with broccoli. delicious.
Yes, Beatrice, is that hot or cold? I think it's probably hot. Mm. I don't like cold broccoli. I don't like cold vegetables generally.
No.
Can't eat cold vegetables, but I would imagine that's hot, but that sounds very nice.
Well, you know my rule, Steve. There is a rule that I have. If I ever go out for a meal somewhere, to a pub or restaurant, one thing I insist on is the food has to be hot. I want hot food on a hot plate. So that is my rule. I'm very fussy in that area, to be honest.
Prithviraj, excuse me if I'm pronouncing your name incorrectly, says Happy Diwali.
Oh, okay then.
Anybody celebrating that? Of course, we celebrate that here. Certain communities here will celebrate. Very difficult at the moment. I'm not getting it wrong by saying it's the equivalent to our Christmas. It's a celebration. And because I've been to Diwali events, Mr. Duncan, because I've been invited. A lot of my customers celebrate Diwali, and I've been along to celebrations, and it's fun. It's a bit like Christmas. It feels like Christmas.
Mm. Isn't it Diwali? Isn't it pronounced Diwali?
I'm not sure. Is it Diwali or Diwali? I think it's Diwali. I think the W is pronounced like a V.
Okay,
I think. Please correct me, somebody.
They normally have the Festival of Lights, of course, during Diwali or Diwali. So yes, the Festival of Lights. So that's probably one of the things that's similar to Christmas.
Exactly. That's what my friends who celebrate Diwali have explained to me. It's a celebration a bit like our Christmas.
Mm.
But we're looking for somebody to maybe correct us or even agree with us as to what we said is correct.
So, yes, a lot of...
Diwali.
So, Diwali, yes, so it is. It is.
Not... I was right.
Okay.
Sorry.
I suppose it had to happen eventually.
El Picasso is from the USA.
Oh, hello.
It's nice to see you. We don't get many people watching in the USA, do we?
El Picasso, are you enjoying our English accents? Whenever anyone appears in an American TV show or an American movie and they are British, they often sound like Mr. Steve. Hello, I'm a British person and I'm in an American TV show. So naturally, I will speak like this. But not everyone in England talks like this.
They used to, though. If you look at recordings...
Okay.
Well, we've watched television programmes where they interview members of the public from the 1960s and 70s.
Okay.
And even just ordinary men and women.
When you say ordinary, what do you mean?
Just ordinary workers, ordinary people working. Not aristocracy, who always talk with a posh accent, but even ordinary people were talking, they were being interviewed. They were very crisp and their accents were very clear.
Hmm.
And they were all speaking like this.
Yes, but I suppose...
But we don't anymore.
It depends where they are.
Well, but you watched it as well. You're being contrary now.
I'm not.
Because you agreed with me at the time.
Are you telling me that in the past there were no regional accents?
Oh, no, there were definitely regional accents, but a lot of people did speak in a posh way. I mean, my mother and father came from very humble upbringings. Mm. You know, they didn't come from rich families, but by any means,
no.
Far from it.
Well, wasn't your because your mum was raised in a forest
by wolves,
by wild wolves.
Yes, and yet my parents have got very posh accents. In fact, when I used to go to school, I used to be ridiculed.
Okay,
we moved to the country. We moved to Gloucestershire. And they all speak like that, like they're farmers all the time, you know. And
I can't wait for the subtitles.
And then I went to school and I was, oh, hello, oh, what a lovely day, isn't it sweet? Yeah. And people used to take the mickey out of me.
They used to beat you up, didn't they?
They used to say I was Mr. Posh.
Yes, I wonder why.
I still am, but then when I went to work in Wolverhampton, I lost my posh accent and my mother was very angry.
If you go to live in Wolverhampton, you lose everything.
Yes,
including your dignity.
And your liberty. Yes, I thought you were going to say virginity, you see. I thought that's what you were going to say. Right, I can see a bird, Mr. Duncan. It's a what type of bird is that, Mr. Duncan? It runs up the trees. It's a bit like a woodpecker, but it's smaller.
It's a bit like a woodpecker. Do you mean a nut hatch?
A nut hatch. Thank you, Mr Duncan. I did know. I just thought I'd see if you did.
It's very good that you're pointing out things that no one else can see on the live stream.
My nose is running.
Okay.
My nose, I think it's the smoke from next door's fire.
Is your nose running? You better run away and catch it. I know one thing, it's freezing.
I know. Well, of course, if you're working in the garden, toiling, labouring, then you get quite warm. Of course, you've no idea what that is, do have you, Mr Duncan?
Sorry, what? What was that last bit of the sentence?
Well, I mean, you know,
just goes
do you
into...
ever labour? Do you ever toil? Do you ever feel the burden of having to get jobs done outside and use all your physical activity to get it done?
Well,
I'm talking just... complete rubbish, Mr Duncan.
Well, of course, because I have you. I don't need to do it. I've got you.
Yes. We do talk fast sometimes.
Yes.
Are we excited about Christmas, says Jojo?
Well, of course I am. I love Christmas. I love the festivity. Even though neither of us is religious. So I'm not a religious person. Mr Steve isn't. So yet we still love Christmas. We love the feeling. We love the festivity. So on Wednesday, I was actually on the roof of the house putting lights everywhere on the house. So they are all over the house right now. There are lights. I haven't turned them on yet. I will be doing that on the 1st of December.
It's a long time since you've turned anything on, Mr Duncan.
So I will be turning them on around about the 1st. In fact, we could turn them on to celebrate the end of lockdown. That would be good, wouldn't it?
We could do.
Oh, yeah.
I think I got away with that. Do you think 13th is a lucky number?
Well, some people believe that 13 is unlucky because I think it has something to do. I might be wrong here, but I think it has. There is a biblical reference, I believe,
What's
as well.
That? What has a biblical reference?
Because it is the Last Supper.
What?
You see, 13 people.
Oh, yes, you could be right there, yeah. Yes.
But, yes, there are very various reasons why 13 is considered unlucky. There is actually a phobia. You can be afraid of it. Do you know what the fear is called?
No.
Triskaidekaphobia. Triskaidekaphobia is the fear of the number 13.
Did you know that, Mr Duncan?
Well, I must have, because it came out of my brain.
You're such a brainiac.
Oh, thank you very much.
And obviously you love the comment by Wise Laura Skodska. Probably not pronounced that correctly. Saying that you look sexy with your beard.
Oh, thank you very much. A lot of people have commented on my beard. Now, the reason why I grew this originally was because I was making a lesson about Halloween. So I thought I would grow a slight beard, but then I kept it. And now everyone keeps saying, oh, Mr Duncan, we like your beard. It makes you look very distinguished.
Not everybody likes it.
Mr Steve doesn't like it, but I said it would tickle his fancy, but he disagrees.
Well, you got food stuck on it, didn't you, on Sunday?
Did I?
That was most amusing. I had to wipe it off.
I don't remember that.
Because you looked unpresentable. We were eating the scone, and you had a little bit of cheese your beard. So I had to wipe it off because it was offending people. In fact, I think we sent several people out off the live stream altogether.
There's no answer to that. I don't know why. We don't have live captions anymore. When we're doing the live stream, I really hope that we can get them back. But sadly, we don't have any live captions. It's because of YouTube, not because of us. It's nothing to do with us.
I think it's about to rain.
I think it's going to rain. Well, I'm not staying for much longer. I just wanted to come out and say hello. So I will be going in around about...
Ah. Maria agrees with me over the beard.
Oh, I see.
Thank you, Maria.
Okay. Is that it?
Well, I just saw the comment.
I see.
Not everybody likes your beard.
Well, what's the agreement, though?
Well... Maria said, I agree with you, Mr. Steve.
But it could be about anything.
No, it was definitely about the beard.
It could be about your cauliflower cheese.
That was ages ago. There's only a 30-second delay on this, Mr Duncan.
Yes, OK.
I haven't said anything controversial yet or anything that might get you chucked off YouTube.
No, you haven't.
Say something.
You haven't come out with any racist comments like last Sunday.
That wasn't racist.
No, anyway, let's
not go there.
Let's just draw a line through that and across it. And
we've got nothing to eat after your live stream. We've got no tea cakes, no scones. Just fresh bread that I've defrosted earlier.
I'm going to have a hot muffin.
Really?
There is nothing nicer than a hot muffin. Have you ever had a hot muffin, Mr. Steve?
Not for a few years.
Oh, Maria says, I think the beard is not hygienic.
I agree.
I wash my beard.
It's probably full of coronavirus. In fact, when coronavirus first started... They did say, there was a comment, that if you had a beard, then it was unhygienic because the viruses could sort of lodge themselves in your beard. That could happen.
That sounds like a load of rubbish to me.
That's true. You ought to shave it off because, you know, you're putting me at risk.
I think you're lying.
You're putting me at risk, Mr. Duncan, all those diseases that are festering away.
I have not heard any evidence about that.
Oh, it's all out there. I think the chief medical officer mentioned it.
See, Jojo,
one of his briefings.
Jojo says, I like your beard, Mr. Duncan. I like it a lot.
Don't say that. Don't say that. I'm trying to persuade Mr. Duncan to get rid of it.
I'm going to grow it until it's long, like Santa Claus or David Letterman.
Nobody knows who David Letterman is.
But everyone knows who David... Why do you think people don't know things?
Some people will, I'm sure they
will. Of course they will. They have television sets. They have the internet.
They're going out of fashion, beards, Mr. Duncan. Out of fashion.
I just love the way sometimes Steve assumes no one knows anything that we're mentioning. So maybe Tom Cruise, you see. You say Tom Cruise... Steve will think no one will know who Tom Cruise is.
Oh, everybody knows who Tom Cruise
yes.
is.
Well, a lot of people know who David Letterman is.
I used to have a friend that looked like Tom Cruise. He was very popular with the ladies.
He doesn't look like Tom Cruise anymore.
Not now.
He looks a lot like Tom Arnold.
But he was very popular when I was a student. The girls used to be all over him because Tom Cruise, of course, in the 80s, was very popular. And so was my friend.
I think he still is. He still is popular.
Yes, people saying you look handsome with a beard.
Yes. People love this.
Oh, Jojo doesn't agree with me.
They like my...
I don't like you anymore, Jojo.
They like my facial hair. It makes me look distinguished.
It might look all right on camera, but in sort of real life, it's not very nice.
You're just jealous.
I could grow a beard.
He's jealous because I'm getting all the attention, you see.
Yes, they're taking the attention away from me.
Yes.
Well, Mr. Duncan, shall I go inside and put the kettle on?
Yes, because I am going to finish in a moment. I've been on for about 1 hour and 20 minutes.
What temperature do you think it is out here? In degrees Kelvin. No, let's go for centigrade. It's probably... Oh, it's warmer than it should be at this time of the year. 10, 11,
I think maybe the cold weather is going to your brain. Maybe I should replace your brain with the cauliflower. Anyway, off you go, Steve.
bye-bye. See you all on Sunday. I'll be careful not to...
There goes Mr. Steve. He's gone now. And I will be going in a moment. I hope you've enjoyed this. Something unusual today. It is freezing cold here in the UK. Yes, Mr. Steve is going into the house now. He's going to put the kettle on. Not cattle. Kettle. He's going to boil some water and make a nice cup of tea. Thank you for your company. Yes, this was just a short live stream today. Something short. Something different, I suppose. What are you doing, Steve?
phone.
So as I prepare to say farewell to everyone. Thank you very much. You look like the actor Michael Lonsdale, who is a British-French actor. He died a few days ago. I know who you mean. Wasn't he in James Bond? Michael Lonsdale. I know who you mean, yes. He had a very similar beard. His beard looked very similar. But I'm sure he was in a James Bond film. Am I right there? Did Michael Lonsdale play a villain in James Bond? I'm sure he did. I think so. Anyway, it's time for me to go because I'm freezing cold and I have to go into the house now and have a nice hot cup of tea to warm myself up. I hope you've enjoyed this live stream. Something unusual. Yes, I am back with you on Sunday, 2 p.m. UK time. So not tomorrow, but the day after tomorrow, I will be back with you again, as live can be. I think we will be in the studio on Sunday because the weather this week or this weekend is going to be terrible, unfortunately. Thanks for your company. Thank you for watching for the past hour and 20 minutes. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you very much for your lovely, lovely messages. Don't forget, there will be captions later. So later on, there will be captions. Thank you very much. And don't forget, if you want to make a donation as well, I am accepting donations for my work because everything I do for free. And I've been doing this for over 14 years. So I will see you again on Sunday. I'm going into the house now because I'm freezing cold. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of English, saying thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this. See you later. Oh, Sean Ferry says, oh, I'm late. Don't worry. You can watch this again. We had some interesting moments today, most of them from Mr. Steve. See you later. Take care. And I will see you on Sunday. Thank you very much. I'm going into the house now. For the final time, enjoy English, stay safe, stay happy, keep that smile on your face, wherever you go, amongst the human race. And of course, you know what's coming next. Yes, you do. Ta-ta for now.